You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at what's new in image captioning, human parody goodness. We're going to see how it's done. We're going to see how you can do it. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about what's new with image captioning. I've got a special guest. Varsha, why don't you introduce yourself? Tell us who you are and what you do.
Yes. I'm Varsha, Program Manager on Azure Cognitive Services team, and I work on pre-built computer vision offerings like object detection, image tagging, and image captioning.
Fantastic. So let's start first with people, if they don't know about what Microsoft has to offer with computer vision, let's start there. What does Microsoft have to offer with computer vision?
Sure. Let's start with computer vision service. So Cognitive Services vision offerings gives you access to advanced algorithms that process images and returns information based on visual features, whether it's tagging content in images or detecting objects, identifying entities, or even actions between these entities, essentially helping our customers extract insights from images.
And what else?
And image captioning is part of the computer vision service, and it's designed to let you automatically extract content and generate human readable image captions.
It's like we're the same person. I was literally going to dive in, but we're talking about image captioning specifically. You mentioned a little bit about what it was, but what is image captioning? What is it that we offer? Let's start there.
Yeah, so I'm excited to share the recent milestone we established with image captioning. Our research team developed a new approach to image captioning, and this breakthrough technology has helped us achieve human parity on NoCaps benchmark dataset. So NoCaps is novel object captioning at scale. This is roughly used as an indicator of advancement in image captioning algorithms. So the image that you're seeing on the right has been pulled out of the NoCaps test dataset, and the caption generated is through our AI model. And set to be completely honest, it took me a while to realize that there's a table behind the waffle cone there. So it's pretty impressive.
That is amazing. I'm a computer vision person to the level of like classifying images and telling if it's like a cow or a horse. I'm pretty good at that kind of thing. But image captioning that's this good, how do we do that? Can you give us a look inside at how we're getting this kind of human level captioning?
Yeah, so let's start with the process of image captioning and why it's such a complex challenge. So the illustration that I'm showing here shows sort of the translating images into words and the complexity associated with it. So consider for a moment what it takes to sort of visually identify and describe something to another person. And what if this person does not have access or can't see the object that you're trying to describe, right? So every detail sort of that you capture through your human eyes matters. So how does a machine sort of decide what information is important and what's not? You'll need to know exactly what everything is, where everything is, and what it's doing in sort of relation to other objects. And while also sort of understanding what is the foreground and what information is important and what isn't. So you really sort of need to understand what's going on. And a machine needs to be able to summarize this and also describe it in natural language description.
That's really cool. I mean, can you go back one slide? Because I think people are missing you need to know every little thing in there, and then you need to know how to arrange the words so that it makes sense. Because if you said dog, cat, table, that's not really a good sentence. But knowing where everything is actually really cool as well. Sorry I interrupted you. I just wanted to point that out, that it's actually kind of a hard problem.
For sure. And even with the fine tuning, we do generate multiple instances of what we think is a human natural language sentence and with a confidence score. So customers are able to sort of pick it up in terms of what localization and what tags are more important to them.
Awesome.
Moving on to sort of how these image captioning systems are designed. They're typically trained with data sets that contain images paired with sentences that describe these images. So it's sort of a set of captioned images. And in this training set, there's a combination of COCO data set, which is about 80 object classes with captioned images. And there's also open image data set, which is about 600 classes with just object tags. There are no captions associated with it. And what makes this NoCaps challenge even more challenging is it tests how the model is able to describe sort of the novel unique objects that are present in the testing image, but not in the training data set. In this example here, the Coco object classes, for example, like dogs, bench, or umbrella, there are images in the training data set with captions and descriptions. Whereas for open images that you're seeing, whether it's goat or dolphin, it's just object tags. There are no captions present. But on the right, you'll see how well the model performs on even out-of-domain object classes like dolphin.
So how does it know about... So every class of thing that it can look at, obviously it needs to know about that, and it's been trained on these open image data set as well as the Coco data set. Is that how it gets knowledge about the actual things that are there?
Yeah. So with the Coco data set, there are descriptions associated, right? So you're sort of understanding the semantic coupling between the different tags, between the dog and the bench. The dog is sitting on the bench, or the child is sitting on the couch. Whereas with open images where just tags are present, there's very little information that the model gains from just the tags. There's no semantic coupling. There's no dolphin in the water. But as you can see, while we test this model, the out-of-domain knowledge is equally good. A dolphin is swimming close to the ocean, so the water coupling is happening with the novel unique object that the model is seeing.
That's cool. I feel like I want to see some examples of like things that it's captioned. Do you have anything like that?
Yeah, for sure. You're reading my mind.
Yeah, see? It's almost as if we looked at this and talked about it together before. Almost.
Almost. Let's take a look at a few examples that we tested both with our previous model that was released in 2015 and with the latest human parity model. So as you can see, this the older model gave us a caption of close-up of a plant, and now it's a close-up of a wheat in a field, which is much more accurate.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty amazing.
Yeah, and even here, it's... The older model gave us an update of a blue shirt or a man wearing a blue shirt, right? And now we can see it's surgical mask. It's a lot more contextual and in specific domain.
This is really cool because, I mean, look, back when I was a programmer, right, I would get data that's like in a database and with numbers and with even strings, you could do stuff with text. But with images, it was hard to actually figure out like what's actually going on in an image. And now with this, you can totally just do it, which is pretty amazing.
As you can see, the model is extracting more of these unique objects present in the image and generating, in many cases, more accurate description of the images.
And this is cool.
And this is one of my favorite ones, where AI model is not just detecting objects present in the image, but also sort of conveying the intent behind it. So the new caption generated is a person making bread, which clearly is sort of the intent and the insight that you want to decipher from the images.
Yeah, because like if I squint, it kind of does look like a person cooking hot dogs on a cutting board. But now when you look at it with actual, you can see that there is intent behind a person. I mean, it's pretty cool that it's capturing that as well. Like you've shown me so many good pictures. Now, can we take a look at how can I use this today?
Here, I'm showing a quick demo of how the API can be integrated into your application. To access Azure Cognitive Services API, you need the Azure subscription. So you can create one for free using our free pricing tier. Review the subscription and create the resource in specific deployment region. Once you have Azure subscription, create a computer vision resource in the Azure portal and get access to your key and endpoint. You will need the key and endpoint for the resource you create to connect your application to the computer vision service. You'll be pasting your key and endpoint in the application code, so let's copy them over. Now let's pull up my Jupyter notebook to see this in action. So here I'm importing Azure Cognitive Services and system libraries. Let's run that through. Once that's imported, we'll add the subscription key and Azure endpoint. Running that through, and here's the interesting part. So the API can take in a URL and also a local image path. So Seth, I'm going to put you on the spot here.
Let's do it.
Do you want to give this a go?
Yeah, let's do it.
Copying the URL of this picture now. And let's change the URL path. Perfect. Let's run that through. And voila. group of people watching fireworks.
Let's try one more. Let's search for Seth Juarez. Here, I'll spell my name. Let's see if it knows who I am. Computers are funny. So just S-E-T-H and then J-U-A-R-E. There we go. Let's see if it finds a picture of me. The one to the right of that, because that's the one to the right. There you go. Try that one. Let's try that picture. Let's see if it knows me or this guy, because maybe I was talking to a really famous guy and I just had no idea.
Let's do it.
All right, there we go. Now let's try it. Boom.
Perfect.
Okay, here we go.
Man sitting at a table looking at a laptop.
Yes! It knows that I'm sitting at a table looking at a laptop. Look at that. How cool is that? So this is cool. It seems pretty easy. You just basically set up the service. You put in the key and you just start sending pictures to the thing. And it can be a URL or it could be something you push up locally. Is that right?
Yep, exactly.
That's awesome. So what else is new with computer vision? Do you have anything new that we should be thinking about as well?
Yes, we've had a ton of updates this fall. We 3.1 version of computer vision API is generally available, and we've updated SDKs for Python, Java, C#, and JavaScript. And these latest AI capabilities are integrated with Intel and Microsoft products and available to our customers using Office products.
I didn't think about that. Like, Office is using these things internally right now?
Next slide, I'll show the integrations that are currently in our Office products.
Okay. All right, let's take a look.
The enhanced image capturing model is already in our production service and is available in the latest version of our computer vision API. The service provides a flexible deployment option, enabling developers to use this capability to both improve accessibility in their own applications and in services. The AI capability is already being used in Seeing AI, Microsoft's assistant mobile app for visually impaired, where a user can take a snapshot of their surroundings and computer vision describe API will return the description to help the users understand the scene and sort of participate in the conversations. And image captioning is also being used for tasks like creating alt text for images. And this is available through our Microsoft Office products like Office, Outlook, Word, and PowerPoint.
This is really cool. Where can people go to find out more to get started on using this good stuff?
Yeah, to get started, we have a bunch of resources available online. You can visit Azure Cognitive Services portal or directly go to developer documentation on microsoftdocs.com. Look through API references, concepts, quick start guides, and tutorials. If you have questions or feedback, you can also contact us through Azure Cognitive Services customer support.
Well, this is absolutely amazing. I've enjoyed looking at this. Like I said, I love computer vision. It's one of my favorite things. It's cool to see it actually generating captions and doing all this good stuff. Thank you so much for spending some time with us, my friend.
Thank you.
And also, thank you so much for watching. We've been learning all about the new image captioning inside of computer vision. Thank you so much for watching, and hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.